Oh, class 4 students, today I will discuss first chapter of science, its questions and answers. You remember, well remember, the name of the chapter is matter. So I will discuss the question and answers and exercise of the chapter matter. First you open your book and come to page number 13. See here, it is written here, it is asking time please. A. Identify the state of matter for each of the following arrangements of particles. These particles are there. These round balls, they represent particles in liquid, gas or solid. In a liquid, gas or solid. C. As you know, in solid, they are compactly packed. See, the gap is, there is no gap between them. They are compactly packed. So this is, when the gap is, there is no gap, that is called solid. When there is some gap, that is called liquid. So we can say they are loosely packed, or we can see they are not so closely packed. This is blue shape. You see, these are liquid. Example of liquid, this is example of a liquid. Now come to gas. Here they are very very loosely packed. See, so they have no definite shape. This has no definite shape, and this has definite shape. So see, these are the arrangements of your particles. You write here liquid, then gas, then solid. Next question, give two examples for the following. Solid, you can see in the back page, you can give two examples, pencil and computer. Liquids, water and milk. Gases, wind and steam. Steam is water vapor, that is in gaseous state, water in gaseous state. Now come to page number 14. Let's investigate. I am reading it out. Take some water in a mug. Soak a small handkerchief in this water. Soak matlab bhigo do aap. Rumal bhigo aap pani ke andar. रिंज इट, उसको आप धो पानी से, देन ड्राई इट आउट, फिर ऊपर बाहर उसको सुखा लो. आंसर द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन योर ऑब्जर्व. आप क्या देखते हैं, जो पाते हैं उसको आप लिखिए. डज वाटर हैव ए फिक्स शेप? नो, वाटर डजंट हैव ए फिक्स शेप. इट चेंजेस इट्स शेप अकॉर्डिंग द कंटेनर इन विच इट इज फिल्ड. द वाटर इज चेंजेस इट्स शेप अकॉर्डिंग टू द कंटेनर इन विच इट इज फिक्स्ड. इट इज द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ ए लिक्विड that it has no fixed shape. So water is a liquid, so it does not have a fixed shape. Now question number second, this answer is no. Question number second, does water take the shape of the mug? Yes, it takes the shape of mug. If you pour the water in glass, it will shake the shape of glass. So water takes the shape of the container in which it is poured. Now third question, does the shape of the handkerchief changes once it is placed inside a mug? See, you can write yes and no as well. If it is yes, you can say that it occupies less area. The when you soak this your handkerchief in water, its overall shape does not change. It's required remains the same. Surface area changes, because it, when you soak it, it becomes like this type. It becomes closely packed, becomes like this shape. So it is becomes compact. So you can say it is changes its shape. What happens to the water present in the handkerchief when it is dried in the sun? When it is dried in the sun, it dries up and its water vapors leave the handkerchief surface and go to the atmosphere. So there is evaporation takes place there on the surface of the handkerchief, and it dries up, your handkerchief dries up. So evaporation takes place. You write here evaporation takes place and it dries up. Evaporation takes place. Evaporation takes place and it dries up, and it dries up. You can write this. Now come to exercise part 16. Fill in the blanks with the correct words. Matter exists in, you know very well, three states. Case gases and liquids are also called as fluids. Fluid means the things which can flow. Fluids has come from the word flow. So gases and liquids, they can flow, so they are known as fluids. The particles are packed very tightly with each other in a solid, you know better. In liquid, they are loosely packed. Next, fourth question. The process by which water changes into water vapor is called boiling. Okay? Because of heat, then it changes into water vapor. This is called boiling. Fifth question. Snow melts to form. It does not condense, but it melts to form water. Okay? Because it gets heated up and slowly, slowly snow changes into liquid water. Now, B. Tick the correct option. Which of these is not a correct state of matter? Water cycle is not the correct state of matter, because we know water exists. We know water exists in three states. Solid state is snow, liquid state is water, and vapor state is vapor or steam. So water cycle is odd one out. It is not a state of water. It is a cycle only. In which of these processes do we need to heat the liquid? In boiling, we heat the liquid. It changes into vapor. So, correct option is A, boiling. Which of these processes help in rainfall? Condensation. First, water heats up. Then it evaporates. After heating, evaporates and go to atmosphere. Here, condensation takes place. It comes in contact with cold there. It becomes cooler and cooler as it goes, moves high up. Water vapors, it becomes cooler and cooler, and this is the cause of rainfall. After cooling, it becomes heavy, becomes liquid water, and it comes to the ground. This is called rainfall. So all the three are needed: heating first, then evaporation, then condensation. These are needed to have rainfall. Now short answer the following. You can do it from the defined matter. Name the different states of matter. You know the definition of matter. Anything which has mass or occupies space, that is called matter. You can take write it from the also from your chapter. Name the different states of matter. You know that very well. Solid, liquid, and gas. How can you change the shape of a solid? By applying force you can change the shape of solids. You can find this answer in your book also. By applying force, you can change the shape of solids. Define water cycle. You can see this a figure here, define water cycle. You can go there, and here is water cycle. You see, page 14, this is your water cycle. Okay? The water evaporates, goes upwards, then condenses, cools down, becomes heavy, and comes down again. This process goes on and on. This is called water cycle. Okay? You can note down from this 14 and learn. Now, explain the different states of matter with the help of examples. Here, examples are given here, solid, liquid, and gas. You can explain them. And examples are given in this page. They are different. Example of solid and this liquid and gas. So I have done your first question of long answer. Now second question, D part of long answer. Draw diagram to explain the arrangement of particles in different states of matter. So you have to draw arrangement of particles. See, you can draw this one. You have to draw these circles. This is solid, closely packed. Liquid, not so closely packed. Gases, they are free to move, and they are relatively loosely packed, very loosely packed. So you can draw these diagrams. Okay, you can draw these three diagrams. Now last question, I think we have come to last question. Describe how matter changes its state with the help of water as an example. You can find this answer here, change of state. Go to change of state, changing states of matter. So you can see, you can read it out and make the answer from matter can change from reading read out and you frame your answer. Matter can change its form from one state to another either by heating or cooling. Ice melts to water when it is kept outside the freezer. You know very well the process by which a solid changes into liquid is called melting. So solid changes into liquid is called melting, and this is how this affected by heating. As it gets heat from the surrounding, it melts. When a liquid is cooled, it changes into solid. If we keep water back into the freezer, it will become ice, solid. That is the process by which a liquid changes into solid is called freezing. This is the reverse process of melting. It is changing of liquid into solid. That was changing of liquid solid into liquid. This is liquid into solid. Now last one is boiling water. Boiling is the process in which liquid is heated. When water is heated through enough, it changes into water vapor. When a liquid changes into gas on heating, it is called boiling. So these are the changing states of matter. Okay, now I have finished my chapter. You write in your notebook, fair notebook, and send it to the group. Okay.